Welcome to Creamer Media's Resources Watch, a weekly video roundup of the events and people making and shaping the news in the mining industry. This week, Goldfields expects to complete feasibility studies on its current projects by the end of 2012. AngloGold parries nationalisation, and Metmar is keen to expand its chrome business in South Africa and Zimbabwe. Projects currently featured in gold producer Goldfields' growth portfolio include projects in South Africa, Ghana, Peru, Finland and Mali.
If you look at some of the projects, we might see Chuquipaca in Peru could be about a 500,000 ounce a year producer. You know, we have half of that. If we do Arctic Platinum, it could be between 400,000 and 500,000 ounce a year gold equivalent. If we did, Damang, I think, could certainly add another 250,000 ounces a year. You know, those are three of the more advanced projects at this stage. By the end of 2012, we're going to be making construction decisions on two, if not three, of these at that point in time, and that's quite exciting for us.
South Deep, first of all, on track, and the infrastructure projects in particular are going well.
We are investing massively into the South African assets, and you know, we are building, you know, the new era mine of the future in South Africa that no other company is doing, South Deep. And as you know, we're ploughing in, you know, something like $1 billion on top of a $3 billion acquisition that we're putting into that. And we're also putting in a lot of money into the other operations in terms of sustaining capital. So we're investing massively into South Africa. You know, I wouldn't want people to think that this company is only focused internationally. You know, South Deep is a 35 million ounce project, and let's not forget, it's the most advanced of all of our projects.
If we look at the Damang Super Pit, we have done a lot of work over the last 3 or 4 months to drill out the area and understand the potential below the base of the existing Damang pit, and also to the north at Huni and to the south at Juno. If we're going to take this up to 4 or 5 million ounces, we don't want to be mining this at 240,000 ounces a year. You know, we need to look at expanding the production base. So part of that feasibility study is evaluating whether we build a brand new plant on site and doubling production at Damang.
It's great to see the gold price where it is today, but I think we're not going to get carried away, and we're going to keep our feet on the ground. And the important thing about all of the growth projects that we're looking at into the future is that these projects have got to be sustainable at robust gold prices.
Booming South African gold miner AngloGold Ashanti gave notice of its intention to deliver a nationalisation parrying econo-socio model. Martin Creamer has the story.
South Africa's biggest gold miner, AngloGold Ashanti, has presented a record set of results in an era of record gold price.
I'm happy to report a record earnings result for the quarter against the backdrop of a record gold price. It appears the gold market is entering the perfect storm.
We've got issues in South Africa at the moment. The N-word crops up. Near mine communities need to be looked at differently. And you working on a possible eco-social model that could be different?
Well, certainly every country in the world is in a debate around resources and how communities can better share in the benefits from mining. I think that's a totally legitimate discussion. My issue on the N-word is, unfortunately, the problem is much worse than, or the solution that's being put forward is much worse than the problem. The real issue is community interaction, making sure the local communities benefit more from our activities. So understanding how we can do that, because you have to do it with the federal government, the provincial governments, the local communities, understand how we can play a much more constructive part in those communities is what we've got to learn to do and articulate better from an industry point of view. So we're certainly committed to that type of model. We have youth unemployment in excess of 15%. We should be, with our thinking caps, working with others to work out how we can impact and improve those numbers and improve the contributions we make that's more tangible and more real to the local communities. That means we've got to work with all of the stakeholders.
JSE-listed Metmar aims to become one of South Africa's top 10 chrome players in the next 10 years.
Chrome is something we believe in. It's we believe that demand for chrome will continue to grow. We see the Chinese wow factor continuing for the next 10 years. And if you're going to be in stainless steel and there's going to be stainless steel consumption, you're going to need chrome units to produce that stainless steel. About 70% of world's chrome reserves sit in South Africa. An additional 15% approximately sits in Zimbabwe. So between Zimbabwe and South Africa, 85% of the world's chrome reserves are in this part of the world. So if you're going to be in chrome, this is the place to be in chrome if you want to be there long term.
For mining news as it breaks, stay logged on to miningweekly.com and register for our free daily newsletter.